Hello.
All right, cool. Sorry about that. My mic wasn't even plugged in when I had started this. That's crazy. Okay. We're back. Last stream 7 days ago. We're trying to really break the habit of like streaming once, and then like not streaming for 9 more years. So we're trying to get a little bit more consistent with it. So what's up today? Something really fun that I did recently that I want to share with you guys. Something I have been doing recently, actually. And I wanted to try with something I did last year. So it's been like a whole year since the last time I did like an illustration. I've just been kind of doing studies ever since then. So I've been taking old art and then like refining it. So this was on my Instagram, and if I just ignore that, this was just me checking values. If I just I'll scroll down here, zoom in, I kind of want to show you where this started. So this was the original sketch that was on my Instagram that like I posted a while ago. This is like July, and I figured I had done so many like studies of the face and everything about that, and like basic like shapes and basic rendering, that I could try to apply it to this. And so this was the outcome. If I can click the layer, this was the outcome. And I really enjoyed it. I think it shows that I've improved a lot since the last one. And I'll show you the steps that I took to get here. I'm just gonna turn off everything first. I'm just kind of walk through it as we go. So the first thing I did was I duplicated the layer because I wanted to work non-destructively, and merged it down into one sketch. And then I liquefied that sketch to make the eye a little smaller because I didn't like how, you know, large the other one was, just so that way I could start painting. Then I went in with just getting the basic shapes for the face down. That was kind of the first thing I did, establishing form there. And then I hit the arms and a little bit more detail in the face, added a few more darker values, made it a little easier to read. And then after that, I added kind of like a rim light slash cleanup. This is when like I really zoomed in and started to like really like define the shapes within the face, so that way it could be a lot more readable. But this was mostly just me separating the arms out and cleaning up the excess like stuff here. Right after that, I fixed up the hair. So everything dealing with the hair kind of finished up. Including eyebrows, you know, stuff like that. There's also, I think I added a small light layer onto this and fixed up a little bit under the chin. I don't know if you can see that, but like right here, let me grab that, like right there. Yeah, I fixed that, fixed right around here. Turn this on and off, it kind of becomes really visible. And then I added some lights onto the nose to give it a little bit more form. But aside from that, everything else on this layer just deals with hair. Shoulder detailing, I just added some muscle here so that way she doesn't like breaks up the forms a little bit, so that way it's not just a tube for her arm. Makes it a little bit more interesting to look at. And the last thing I did was just render out the clothing. And I kind of just did all the clothing on one layer because I couldn't be bothered to do it anywhere else. I do believe I added the iris, the pupil, in on the clothing layer. But aside from that, everything else is just clothing. So, the tongue piercing, the shirt, the shoes, which now that I'm looking at them, the shoes are kind of in like a weird perspective. But I'm just happy with the fact that this is done, because this is what I've kind of been focusing on since July. I want to do something like that again, and so I've been going back and like trying to like challenge myself to render out more sketches that I have, and I was in the midst of this one. If you want to see what this one looked like before I started it, this was the base coloring that I did. Here's the original sketch. I've kind of just been playing around, messing with and see what can happen. Trying to give it a little bit more form. Just doing some basic stuff. But yeah, we're gonna be doing that, but with like a really, really old piece. not really, really old. Last year, again, this is a piece I did for one of my, for my illustration class, actually. And I think we can make this look a lot better if I go back and refine it and make it something that's worth putting up on my portfolio page and stuff like that. So yeah, we're going to get into this. I want to see, before we start though, if I can find like the like PNG file I have of this, because this is really blurry. If I can find the PNG, then make this a lot easier. If not, I'm just gonna have to work on the JPEG. But we'll see. Okay, yeah, looks like we're just working from the JPEG. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. What I'm gonna do for this stream is just fix up her face and maybe add some definition to her whole body. But yeah, we're just gonna get started. So, here we go, I suppose. Thank you. I think this one would actually just be better if I just paint it over this. Just got rid of that in its entirety. Yeah, that's a lot better. And then just... It does look slightly creepy now, but it's okay. We can fix it. Oh. Aha! Okay. This one will work a lot better. Okay, guys. No. We just got... There we go. Now this one will work. Yeah. This one can be salvaged. Jesus, the last one was... I don't know what that was. Alright. Oh, that's already, like, way, way better. Alright, so first thing I'm gonna do is take this. And shift this over. Already looking better already. And since this character already has a relatively pointy chin, I think that's fine. We'll grab this. And I do one thing just so I can inform myself. Hey Lexi, what's up? What's up? No, we're just trying to get back to streaming. Now I'm gonna see like what type of light would reflect. Of course we would have like this bouncing off, but I'm wondering if any like green would get on. I know there'd be some what's it called, skylight coming in, so I'm gonna grab that. Grab an airbrush and then grab some of the sky color. Maybe saturate it a little bit and then desaturate it a little bit. I want that to be a little bit more like blue. Some of that sky color just hitting the forehead. Trying to get like the right amount so that it doesn't look too bad. Yeah, around that's good. I like the subtlety. I'm gonna grab some red. And just blush in. Some key areas here. Places that would be red. Grab some of the hair color. She looks much, much better than she did when she started, which is crazy. We'll grab some of the darkest shadows that I have here. Now I'm gonna make the base for my eyes, which is weird because like I don't like starting my eyes by just drawing the eyes. I always have like the base shadow in there and then two or three layers of something else, but you'd like. Like, when I draw eyes, it's a whole process. There's definitely a faster way to do it, and I'm trying to learn how to paint them faster. But for me, my most comfortable method right now is just, I take my darkest, I take my shadows, and then, like, I put in, like, the outline of the eye with the shadow. And then I go from there. I should probably change the stream name as well. Give me like 1 second. Let me just change this real quick. I'm gonna change it to Repainting Old Art. Have I improved? Spelled improved wrong. Alright. Anyway. Oh my. No, still on stream. Okay. I should say I'm still on Steam. okay. What do I want to do next? I genuinely don't know. I guess right now I'll tackle the rest of the face. I just want it to make sense. I think that works for now. Ugh. Yeah, I think that works for now. Jesus, her face. I'm just gonna bring that down. I feel like she has a little too many teeth in her mouth. Like, a few too many teeth. I guess this time we'll try and represent the character a little bit more accurately. I know when I originally did this, I did not have, like, the technical ability to, like, I don't know, put in what, like, I actually wanted. So we're gonna try and change that this time around. As soon as I figure out how to properly do teeth, then we can actually do that. Oh, that's why it looked weird. She's at an upward angle and her teeth were facing down. Let me grab a blue. I think a round brush would be better for this one. Dab a little bit of blue in her eyes. A little right there. I'm just gonna keep that as it is. And then grab this, go up a little, and then establish that line. And honestly, if you're watching and like you're an artist, I highly encourage you to like go back and like repaint old pieces every once in a while, because like you don't see how much you've like actually grown. Like clearly you can see it with new pieces, but the way like I guess the way the human eye works and the way like the human mind works is that like you'll always compare yourself to like your most recent and best piece. So in order to like really see your growth, it would be good if you went back on old pieces. Like just so that way you're not saying, oh well, this new piece I'm making isn't as good as the last one. Now you can see how much better you can make, you know, your old piece, if that makes sense. It's weird, my mixer brush just was not coming out for a little bit. She look happy enough, chat? I don't know. I'm gonna add a little bit of red inside like her cheek here for the bounce light for this. There's no reason for it to be that bright. It's not like glowing. Now, this on the other hand, the light from this thing, yeah, that should be pretty bright. So I'm just kinda gonna go ham on this part. Should I fix that shadow color? I really should. Like, it's kind of a... Yeah, that's a lot better. I'm gonna turn that into, like, this. Something's missing, though. Something doesn't feel right about it currently. Still feels slightly off. I don't know. We'll figure it out when we go. I think it's looking a lot better than what it looked like 10 seconds ago. don't know. I find this just like really, really fun. Completely like editing the drawing like this. It's nice. Kind of relaxing for the most part. We start working on a lot of the details now up in the face and really wrap this up. Actually, I'm gonna zoom out for this part. Like, yeah, like around there. I think that's too much dark accents. Yeah, I think that's good enough. What do I want to use here? What color do I want for this? I kind of want red. I want a dark red for this. More desaturated than that. Watch enough of my streams, you'll come to find out that I'm in love with like this specific color underneath the eyes. I don't know. It's something I got from Zinchen, who's an extremely good illustrator. I don't know, I just love having that bold, bold red just there. I think I'm gonna decrease the eye size just a tiny bit. Just a tiny, tiny bit. Jesus. My goodness. That's good. Yeah, perfect. There we go. I'm liking the way it's looking so far. She seems really expressive, really into it. I'm gonna grab a nice little 19 round brush. And just go in here with like a few slightly darker colors. Her eyes were pinkish before, so I'm gonna try and keep that feeling alive just a little bit. Thank you.
I just realized. Pinkish, like up here.
A little bug-eyed, probably off. I'm gonna take the pupils off for a little bit. Instead I'm just gonna imply them with like highlights. I guess that's a really, really bright white. Jesus. I can't figure out the eyes for now. Why does that happen every time I double click? is looking that way, so we're just gonna do that for a little bit and grab that. I made a photo of an upwards nose. I could do this nose score. Could do hypothetically. Clear this one out. We'll give her a nose like this. Simple nose like that. That's an option, but that's also kind of boring. That's a really boring, and I don't like the way that looks. It's aesthetically unappealing. Oh, I'm gonna get everything here for now. We're just gonna undo everything we have for the most part. Go back to my, yeah, I want texture. Thank you. Nah, that ain't it either. Why are noses so hard? Noses should not be this difficult. Get her big smile to work out right now. Right about there should be okay. Getting this to work is gonna be, it's gonna take a little bit. I know this is salvageable, I just don't know how. At least not yet. We'll come back to that. Can I just erase most of this mouth? Not bad. I kind of like this better. Okay, we'll just do all that over again. Finally! We will get rid of all of the bottom teeth. Because that is easier. Yeah, I can't get this mouth to work out. I'm really trying my best. I'm not gonna give up just yet. Might be best to just start over. Just wipe over this entire thing. The clean color. Yeah, just like that. Oh my goodness, the improvement is actually massive. Take the whole like top half of the head, just control trench form of that and just smoosh it down a little bit. Nah. Unfortunately, no. Doesn't work that way.
Thank you.
And okay, I think that's all right for the face for now. I think there's a few things I could do to touch it up, but aside from that, like, nose looks weird, but we'll fix that later. Oh! Hi! thank you. Basically what I'm doing is that I had so much growth since last year that I decided to like step into one of my old paintings and repaint it. So like recently I did this to where this was like a really old piece that I made, but I decided to repaint. And if I look at the original for this one, let me just bring it up. This is what it originally looked like. So I'm repainting it. But since I've gotten so much better in the last like year since that was made. Well, this was made in July, so I suppose like 6 months ish. And yeah, I'm doing the same thing for this one, which was actually made a year ago, like to date. This is what it looked like originally. Well, it looked a little better than this. Let me see if I can find the original image. So it looked like this originally, and you know, it was all right, but I can definitely do a lot better. And so I'm going back in now with all the knowledge that I have, and we're painting on top of it. And so this is the new one. the new facial structure we've come up with, and we're just kind of working it from here. We're gonna fix the hair and everything right after this, and then I'm gonna add some dimensionality to the clothing. In fact, I could probably do that right now. I'll fix up the beads first. But yeah, that's what we're doing right now. Thanks for stopping by. And her hair is in kind of like a bun position, so we're gonna try and mimic that. I'm gonna give it a little bit more volume, just cause this one's kind of flat. But I guess she is kind of tilted upward, so it would make sense that the hair is flat. As a pure black I'm using, I actually don't want to use that. Let's take that away for a second. I'll come back to that. Let's finish up the beads. Yeah, I'm kind of like all over the place just because I'm kind of excited to get into this one. I haven't really done any like illustrating, like personal illustration in almost like a... It's been a while. Most of my streams and everything were having me studying, and really nothing else. So now I can kind of just relax for a little bit and actually see what I've learned from those studies, and they seem to be paying off. What do I like about digital art versus traditional art? Well, for one, there's an undo button. But I also think that you can be a lot more like free with digital art. Like you can have more ideas and do them. Like traditional art, people look at it as such like a high class thing. And I don't really like that. Like it's like, I feel like every time I pick up like an actual paintbrush, I'm expected to make a masterpiece every time. But with a not traditional, digital art, I can kind of just play around and no one's really expecting that much. And then when you do deliver, they're just like, wow, I didn't know this was possible. And I'm like, yeah, anything is possible with digital art. Also, it's literally one of the few mediums you can make look like any other medium. Like in like with oils, yeah, you'll get oils. With charcoal, you'll get charcoal. Acrylic, you get acrylic. But with digital art, like you can turn that into anything. Like that can be any medium you want it to be. And that's what I find so cool about it.
That's what I like about it, honestly. It can be anything you want it to be. Yeah, I hope that answers your question. Digital art's just more fun for me. I get to kind of explore and create this like world that I want. And as I get like better and better at understanding, like, why does it keep doing this? At understanding things, I can kind of improve my rendering skills. I'm gonna look at how I did her nose here, because I have no idea how I was this successful here. And then I'm struggling over here. I'm like, Jesus. Yeah, I have no idea. I still need to do some frontward facing nose studies. That's very apparent. We'll come back to the nose in like a day. I think I might do some lips and nose studies before I go to bed today. That might be really nice. That might be the play. But yeah, it's just a lot more, I don't know, free. What about you? Like, do you like traditional or digital art? Or do you like both? Because personally, I like both. I do both. But I don't know. Something's just a lot more satisfying about digital art to me. I will fix this nose. Like, I have a painting that I've done of a similar nose. Give me a second. Let me go look and see what I did on that one. You like traditional? You like the physicality of having complete components? Like having, okay. No, yeah, I feel you. Like physically, like holding a paintbrush, personally for me, it does feel really, really nice. I do really enjoy that. I do definitely enjoy that feeling. But yeah, I don't know. I kind of like the feeling of having that digital stylus in my hand. I like the flexibility. But yeah, I definitely get what you mean by having the actual physical touch of it. I personally think that, like, it's like at surface value, I think painting digitally is actually a lot harder than painting traditionally, just because you're not used to not having like the texture there for you.
Like, I know personally that was my hardest, like, thing. Like, everything looked too, like, smooth, too computer-generated when I first started. But you kind of just, you get used to it, and then once you figure it out, it all just kind of starts to mesh together. And you kind of start to just conjoin the two. You start to look at them as, like, the same thing. At least I know that's what I did. I start seeing digital art and traditional art as kind of the same thing. I think that looks a lot better for a nose, honestly. Just hit it with a little bit of this. There we go. This works a lot better for like a nose. Maybe simple, but it's effective. Yeah, no, I get that. I get it. I see what you're saying. For me, the physicality just, I guess it doesn't really matter for me because I like to do, really, really, what is it called? Like non-expressive art. Like a lot of the pieces I make aren't necessarily to express myself, but they're either just for practice or to like ideate on something. So like, I don't know. I find that to be the most fun part about art for me, just like the ideation phase, which is kind of like maybe why I want to do like a lot of concept art after graduation. But you know, that's just me. I find that a lot of people really do enjoy like expressing themselves through art. And it's gonna sound weird for me to say this, but like that's not really like my primary reason for doing art. I just really enjoy creating these concepts, bringing things to life, essentially. Like a lot of my work, like there's no like, I think I've said this before, but a lot of my work, there's no like huge overarching like theme behind it, like about who I am and stuff like that. Oh my goodness. Yo, what's up, Brian? I think you've seen this piece. You have it hanging in your room, but I decided to repaint it since I went through this already, but I'll go through it again. I repainted this piece, which was on my Instagram from last year, and it used to look like this. So yeah, I'm just repainting a lot of my old works to see how much I've improved and see if I can make them better. So when I repainted this one, I was not expecting this, but I was like, oh shoot, I have improved a lot. So yeah, we're redoing this one. Yeah, and we're gonna see how it goes, honestly. Oh, Kiana, you're in here too. I didn't even see that it was Kiana came in. Hi, Kiana. Thank you. I did finish the song. interesting story. It's getting a music video for it sometime this week. So that'll be fun. I didn't forget about you, Lexi. need like an airbrush for this. It's so like not soft currently. I think we can change that, like just by doing that. I did make your pizza. Taylor's also here. Oh my goodness. Hi, Taylor. I did make your pizza. And it was weird because I was gonna like say hi to you when you came in. But like, I think when you came to pick up your pizza is when my coworkers asked, where do you live? Because he recently ordered a commission from me and he wanted to come see the sketch. So I was like, oh yeah, after work, I'll show you. He's like, all right, cool. I'm gonna go grab something. Just tell me where you live. And then I'll stop by. And so I walked to the back of the building and pointed at Nisk. And when I came back, I think you were gone because your pizza wasn't on like the rack anymore. And it was there when I left, so. I like that. I like that a lot. We're gonna change the eye size a little bit, but I like that a lot for the time being. Yeah, we're gonna fix all that. It's kind of weird. Taylor, thank you for watching. What is she? Wait, is Taylor with you? Okay. Tell Taylor that. Yes, everything does look out of place. I think she remembers this one. This is an illustration from last year. It's gonna be the fourth time I'm explaining this. yeah, I'm redesigning it, so we're gonna get to all the mistakes and everything, and see if we can make this look a lot better. To see if we can have this one match this one. Yeah. I think the only thing I've done so far in this new one is the face and the beads. But yeah. It does, but that's kind of like the entirety of the point. I think this character, when I designed them, was supposed to be like based off the hybrid of a pig and like, what's it called? Oh goodness, I forgot the thing. A deer. But I couldn't draw it at all. So, you know, I had like very minimal ability to, but now we can kinda. I don't want the nose to look too swine-like, but at the same time, it does look very swine-like. You're right about that. I'm trying to find a way to fix that currently. That was the eraser, whoops. As long as I figure out how to fix the swine-like nose, we'll be in a good spot. But until then, it is what it is. And I guess that's just what she's gonna have.
gonna add a few things now to make this make a little bit more sense. Reduce the nostril size a bit. Yeah, very possible. Let's give it a shot. Oh, it's still on the airbrush. I was like, what is happening? It's starting to rain again. Shall we watch it? Shall we go out in it? Nah, not just because she has like slightly small nostrils. I'll figure it out. I think I have to figure it out at some point. We'll figure out why she looks relatively small. Like, you know what? Maybe like an actual reference would help. Let's figure out why, just for a little bit. Where? I just saw a really good one. Where did it go? Something and hope it works. If not, then we'll try to shrink the base of the nose. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Give me 1 second. Let me try one thing. If this would work, it'd be like very, very nice. That's the wrong skin tone. Does that help at all? I don't know.
think that's slightly better. Not completely, but slightly. That's all that matters. Oh, by the way, Lexi, tell Taylor that congratulations on graduating. Might be slightly late, but you know, you did it. How's the real world treating you? It's a pretty big improvement. Alright, I'm gonna make the rest look not bad. Taylor said this looked messed up. This one. That makes sense. I kind of just freehanded the anatomy when I did this. We can fix that though. Yes, very, very fixable. It's gonna be hard though, that's the thing. I guess we'll start with adding some depth to the clothing first off. I It's 32 minutes ago. I have cookies and ice cream. It's all right, Taylor. We're all with you. On the bright side, though, you know, school is not a thing anymore. You can, like, you know, live your life now. Congratulations on turning 23. Wow, you were only slightly older than me. I don't know why I thought you were, like, I don't know, like, a full, like, year or two older than me. I'm not sure why. congrats. Also, happy birthday. Exclamation mark. Understandable. Me too. You're very welcome, Taylor. I'm gonna add some really, really dramatic lighting because I see no reason not to. I should probably make this scene make sense first before I do that. Wait, so then are you guys celebrating right now? Celebrating Taylor's birthday in your room then? I have milk in a Jersey Mike's. What does that mean? You just have milk in a Jersey Mike's cup? Is that, am I supposed to take that very literally? Is that a metaphor? A euphemism? What? Correct. All right. I listed three options and I'll sit with a correct.
The arm looks.
honestly, not too bad for the night. I want to draw one more thing. Something she was supposed to have in the original, but never gave her because I was too afraid to. Actually, no, I'm going to add two more things. I'm going to finish up the hair. And add this while I'm at it. Kinda. She's meant to be based off like so she's a hybrid of like three different things. I forgot when I made this character, but she's supposed to be kind of like a demon who can see spirits, I guess. And she takes place after, she's based off the Oni in Japanese mythology, which is literally just that. But I wanted to add something interesting to it, so I combined two different animals, and her horn designs are based off those. I'm just blocking in the silhouette, and I'm gonna add to the horn design as I go. But I tried so hard when I first did this to get the horns in, and they just didn't look right. And it was also due the next day when I worked on this the first time, because my time management was atrocious. It didn't really like... I didn't really have the chance to experiment. Kind of did that to myself. But yeah, we're gonna try that now though. Short.
We should find a day to hang out. That would be like very, very, it would be appreciated if we could all get together. I haven't seen like any of you guys aside from like Brian in forever. And that's just because I have class with Brian. Aside from you, Keon, I saw you yesterday. Should have the hair on a different layer. Guess I'm gonna have to fix this with paint. I have a brush that can solve this. Yeah, that's all right. We haven't forgotten. Let's fix this real quick. I don't really like this. Skin tone. Good enough. Is this just not working? That works.
I like that. Thank you. I think that's where I'm going to end this one for the night. I'm going to do... Actually, I lied. Okay, this is where I'm going to end this one for the night. Thank you guys. I'm pretty happy with like just the repaint in general. Went from this to this, so I think it's coming along pretty good. Yeah, I guess I'll finish up her body sometime tomorrow. Probably do some sketches back then. Thank you guys for tuning in. I haven't streamed in years, I know. Thank you guys. I'll see you guys when I see you guys, hopefully soon. You guys have a good night. Good night, Brian. I may or may not walk to the gas station to grab something to eat. I don't know. See you guys.